doing a quick video of this Topo Designs bag. This is the Core Pack. I think it's a new bag that they have. It says it's 25 liters. It's a big 25 liters, which is good. It's a light bag. I think it's under 2 pounds. But it's nice because it has load lifters, sternum strap, and a hip belt. Hip belt's a little thin, but it does the job well. And it's removable too, which is nice. So, but yeah, this real quick. I have this mostly packed out for Gen Con that I'm going to next week. So it's a 5-day trip. We're going up Tuesday night, coming back Sunday. So I'll show you what I have in here. I have, you know, loads of space left even. Just to show you, in here I have my liquids. And the stuff I'm bringing is a little bit different than some of the other videos that I've uploaded. This is more specific. I'm going to Indianapolis. I know what the weather's going to be like, so I've packed more specifically for that. But the Topo inside here, it's a nice light yellow fabric, which is good. It has these two zippered pockets, which is a little annoying because the zipper goes all the way to the side. So, like, I can't find the zipper right now. There it is. So you can, like, zip these up, stick, you know, some stuff in here that you want to keep a little bit organized. It does have a little clip also for keys. I also have my e-reader in here. So yeah, it's a little annoying. I think having maybe some stretchy nylon fabric would have been better, maybe with or without the zipper. The zippers do feel nice. So the main compartment, I don't even know what these are. They're loopy things. I can loop things on them. Okay. Anyway, moving to the inside. So for Gen Con, I have, this is headphones and all my cables, including an aux cable, a portable battery charger for my phone. It's that. I have a sweatshirt, because even though it's summer, I still tend to get cold in hotels. This I'm bringing just to sort of protect my film camera. I'm doing a picture a day type thing on black and white film as sort of an art project that I'm doing. So this is just to kind of protect it a little bit more. And basically I'm just going to be carrying this around until I take a picture and then probably take it back to the hotel. And then this is my packing cube with all my clothes. And that's that, pretty much. It's just one big open pocket. I think it would have been nice maybe to have a little zippered pocket over here. That's not my biggest complaint about this bag, though. It has a slash pocket, which I have just some miscellaneous pills, earplugs. And then I'm not bringing a laptop, but I thought I'd show you the laptop compartment. It just opens up about that much. It's not TSA friendly, but yeah, so if I had my laptop, that's where it would be. This kind of, like, it's fine. It flops when it's unzipped like that because the straps are pretty substantial. The most annoying thing about this bag, though, get it zipped up, is it only has one little carry handle here. It would be super awesome if there was sort of a nicer, slightly beefier strap here, because I find that if I have it on, like this, got it on my back, this is what it looks like, and I go to take it off, the first thing I want to do is grab something here, and there's nothing there to grab. I would have to, like, come and, like, fiddle around to try to grab this. So they really missed the mark not having just a grab handle right here. Grab handles on the side would have been nice, but it's not as big of a deal. It does have two water bottle pockets. I think they could have just done one water bottle pocket and then a grab handle on the side. This is a really nice sized bag, though. I like how much depth it has. It's pretty comfortable to carry. All this stuff, including my laptop, I think was under 14 pounds, just barely. If I was packing for winter, it'd be a little bit heavier, but not too much. I might have two packing cubes because I'd have, you know, bigger pants and, you know, more long sleeves or whatever. But that's that. This is the smaller of the two bags that I got. Now, real quick, this is the 30-liter travel bag. And I may pack it out real quick just to kind of show you, but this I don't like as much. It's not as deep. And there are just some things. This pocket here is similar to the other one. It has two zippers that, again, are kind of hard to unzip and then get into. So these would have been better placed elsewhere, I guess. It has this front sort of thing where, see, these just have slash pockets. And then this is a big zipper that maybe could hold an iPad or something. So that's not too bad. But if I wanted to, let's say, I don't know, put this and then my liquids there. And then this up. Oops. Why is it getting stuck? There. So this opens up. See, this has zipper pockets on the front panel, which I think is nice. But it's not very... I mean, these packing cubes are pretty deep, I will say that. But, and it does, you know, you can pull this up and over. I guess that's not... I mean, you can tell there's a whole lot of room in this thing. I'm just kind of like throwing this in here. This is probably too much bag for me. But just to kind of show you what that looks like. And then the laptop compartment is over, it's a side slash pocket, which is not my favorite kind of laptop pocket. I would prefer, ideally, one that lays out flat. But if not that, then something at the top. So this is what it looks like. Kind of packed out with not much stuff. It also has load lifters, sternum strap, and hip belt. It has a pass-through for rolling luggage if you want. And it also came with a like a messenger bag strap. So this does have the nice grab handles. Why they couldn't have put this on the other bag, I have no idea. But I think this is just way too much bag for me, because see when I put it on, oops. Just feels ginormous. So, yeah, I don't know if you can see big it is on me. I'm like 115 pounds, 5'1". So, that's that for these bags. Also, there's sort of like a mix of different types of fabric, which is interesting. Bright colors you can like clip things on. One thing I'm gonna do real quick is compare this with my 13-liter can Fjallraven bag that I've had forever. Let's see. If you're not interested in that, you can just stop the video now. Make sure I've got everything. Laptop. So. This is my little... holds a 13-inch laptop. This is technically a 14-inch laptop, but it fits. This would not hold a 15-inch. This claims it's 13 liters, I think, and I think the 15-inch bag is 15 liters, 16, maybe 17 liters. But this packing cube is right there in the bottom. This is gonna be a little tight. This here, this here, then I'm pretty sure this will fit this thing holds a surprising amount of stuff. So that's all in there, pretty nice and snug. There's no extra space. This can go in here, and then I would carry the purse with my camera separate, which is fine. So this is the 13 liter Fjallraven Canken backpack, which I love this little thing. It's super light, super small, super easy. So yeah, and then I would just have this separate. So I'm not sure exactly which one I'm gonna take. I am tempted by the smaller core pack. Very tempted by this bag. It's not perfect. It doesn't have the lay flat laptop, which I'm, like I said, I'm not even bringing a laptop this trip. But it's something that's good to have for future trips where I do bring, you know, a laptop. And this laptop grab handle just has me, like, scratching my head how they missed that. So, has pretty big branding on it. It does look like you could easily just remove that with a seam ripper if you wanted to, if you didn't want the branding. Okay. These are these bags. Sorry it was really quick and not very in-depth, but I think you got a good idea of, you know, what could possibly fit in it. Again, be aware of what I'm bringing for Gen Con. And I'm getting a phone call. Decline. Okay, there we go. Clothing wise, what I'm bringing to Gen Con is the sweatshirt. And then this has, pajamas. It's just shorts and a tank. This is the swim top, a bra. I'll be wearing a bra, 4 shirts, and then I'll be wearing a shirt. And these are wool too. I could even get away with not having an extra shirt and just wearing a shirt a couple days in a row because it's wool and it doesn't. I've been testing these wool shirts and going, I don't want to say weeks. Yeah, like 2 weeks. Without maybe wearing them 3 times a week and one of those being exercising in them. And they don't smell. It's amazing. But I have swim shorts, 5 pairs of underwear, and then a pair of, this is a wool cotton blend from Icebreaker that I like. And then these are just cotton capris from Prana. And then I'll be wearing probably longer pants on the plane. But something comfortable and then another shirt. So it's actually, I'm probably like overpacking for a 5-day trip, but you saw how, you know, how little space it took up for the clothes that I bring. So that's that.